Well, poo is just poo, right? Right? Well, what if I told you that you can earn up to $13,000 a year by donating yours to medical research?
The demand for fecal transplants is so high it has created a whole new market for healthy stools. But despite the financial incentive, the Centre for Digestive Diseases is short of donors. Professor Thomas Barodi from the Centre for Digestive Disease joins us now. So, Professor, I mean, we can feel a little bit uncomfortable talking about this subject, but can you explain how one person's stool can help another?
Well, a healthy stool contains a whole complement of bacteria, and bacteria make actually antibiotics, and they're able to kill occult hidden infections. So the most effective therapies for Clostridium difficile diarrhea, which kills about 30,000 in the US, and it wipes it out with a single infusion, 90% cure, 98% with two infusions. So it probably works mostly through antimicrobial agents inside.
So, I mean, your stool says a lot about your health. I think we all, all sort of know that. But if you wanted to be a donor, what do you do from that point? Because that might be a bit messy.
Well, you'll have to go through a process of questions.
We all know what you mean.
Not that messy.
maybe someone needs to look at this.
Needs treatment, needs a transplant. So, yes, we go through a process of asking a series of questions, and then we test blood, test stool, and around 1 in 12 end up qualifying. It's not easy to get a healthy poo.
So how do you donate? What do you actually physically do?
Well, we obtain your details, which will be given out, and we can then ask you to answer questions on a telephone. If you pass that spot, then we do blood and stool test, and we look at those and then contact you to see if you're one of the 12.
But if you are, how does the process of donation go?
Once that's through, then we have the donors drop off their little specimen first thing in the morning on their way to work, and then we go through the process of homogenization and preparing it for infusion that day, or making it into freeze-dried lyophilized capsules, which we call crapsules for short.
I love that you say that with a straight face. Yeah. So, okay, well, for one, I like that they're not brown.
Yeah.
Because I think that's probably something that people struggle to get their head around.
That's right.
Eating poo. Mm. But it's they come in the capsule form, but you can also have a transplant, correct?
Yes, the liquid transplant probably is, at this stage, the best. The capsules are double encapsulated, so you're not actually eating poo. It's like any probiotic that you might get elsewhere, because it's just freeze-dried bacteria. But that goes through the freezing and unfreezing, so they've been knocked about. So the fresh is best, naturally, if you know what I mean.
So, who benefits from this? Why would somebody need that? And how does it fix them?
Okay, the disease that I mentioned, Clostridium difficile diarrhea, causes enormous diarrhea, 15, 20 stools per day. It kills, in Sydney we've had 42 deaths, the best I can figure out.
Wow.
But in the US it's 30,000 per year on average, 500,000 infections. And they die from kidney failure, blood pressure loss, and elderly people especially are affected. So a single infusion gives them life, and it's simple as that.
Well, we do hear these days how our good health comes down to having a good gut. So I guess this is what this is all about. And can I just apologise? I've realised we've got a poo emoji behind your head, Professor.
It's actually a serious. It's a serious thing.
It is a serious thing. But
well, I collect those. Yeah. They should bring them.
Yeah. It's good to have a little bit of sense of humour about it, though.
You do. You do. It is poo after all.
And it's an earner. Like, if you're making money from your poo, then hey, who's the smart guy?
$50 a pop or $50 a poop?
Thereabouts.
There.
It's not bad. You can make your money sitting down. Professor, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
All right. Coming up.